family's alien encounter case drawing national attention. Thomas and Matt Reed say as young boys, they were taken from their home by odd-looking creatures. Matt now lives in Brownsburg and says he had another encounter in 2009. They're both here this morning to share their story. And I want to start with, I know there are a lot of people watching that are going to say, what are you guys talking about? This is crazy. I know that you guys take it very seriously and you're offended when people say, don't take you seriously, right?
Well, I don't know if it's really that. I just think that you have to look at the facts, and the facts speak for themselves. I mean, there was radiation, there were magnetic fields. It was discussed at the United Nations in 1992. It's a credible family. My father was in politics. Mm-hmm. Senator Dodd was a backer of my father. This happened back in the 1960s.
The first time?
Yeah.
Okay.
And it was kind of historic in some respects, but it was kept quiet. Mm-hmm. And then in 2009, when Matthew was involved with his case here, it kind of fueled everything,
yeah.
And it was taken very, it was handled very professionally.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about what did happen, and let's start with 2009.
Right.
What happened, and describe to us, and I know we have some photos and some pictures of things.
Right. In 2009, it was a typical evening, and a friend and I came back from a movie, and essentially saw this orange ball of light, started to follow it. My vehicle completely shut down. There was almost $2,000 worth of damage to the vehicle, the electrical system. I have an hour and 32 minutes of missing time. I do have flashes of what occurred then, but when I contacted my brother, because he's been documenting this for nearly 30 years, a team of professional investigators from a privately funded aerospace company came out, and they documented the fact they found trace radiation on my vehicle, strange magnetic anomalies to my vehicle, and what caused this is now all of a sudden we have some professionals that are now investigating the case, and they went back through our family history with a fresh set of eyes. One of the officers has over 30 years of crime scene investigation experience and reevaluated everything that occurred, and then we could suddenly see patterns that have occurred since the 60s.
It's pretty interesting that Discovery Channel and Travel Channel have contacted you. Have you guys done the interviews yet, or what's in store for? Are they doing the story on the two of you and your family?
Yeah, we've been contacted. I've spoken to Angela, Brad Musso's Decoded. Mm-hmm. We've already shot with one network. We have Discovery Channel, which will be actually filming our documentary right down the road from here, mm-hmm. your backyard, I think.
In Brownsburg?
Yeah, and that's they're going to be at my house on April 28th.
Okay.
And to start filming the first week of May. And it looks to be, it's going to be a full-blown hour series, and it's a documentary. It's going to have all the facts. It's going to have everything. It's not going to be one of those crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're out of time, unfortunately, but we didn't really get to scratch the surface, but I know that we'll be following you with this Discovery, okay, and the different channels and kind of getting more into what you all say happened, mm-hmm, and as other people try to say, did it really, or what's the evidence? You know, I know you guys have taken polygraphs and everything.
That's right
now,
there.
You've got people who are saying, hey, we believe it. So, it happened. Good luck to you, and maybe come back
much
after, you know, right, the investigation kind of clears up, too.
You're
thank
welcome. Thank you, Angela.
It's 8:17. We're going to talk to Ron about weather, rain, and if it's going to be sunny today.
Yeah, you know.